Today's Mass Readings. August 31, 2020. Monday of the 22nd week in Ordinary Time. First Reading. A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 1 to 5. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, proclaiming the mystery of God, I did not come with sublimity of words or of wisdom, for I resolved to know nothing while I was with you, except Jesus Christ, and Him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and much trembling, and my message and my proclamation were not with persuasive words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of spirit and power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. The Word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. Psalms chapter 119 verse 97 to 102. Let our response be, Lord, I love your commands. How I love your law, O Lord! It is my meditation all the day. Lord, I love your commands. Your command has made me wiser than my enemies, for it is ever with me. Lord, I love your commands. I have more understanding than all my teachers, when your decrees are my meditation. Lord, I love your commands. I have more discernment than the elders, because I observe your precepts. Lord, I love your commands. From every evil way I withhold my feet, that I may keep your words. Lord, I love your commands. From your ordinances I turn not away, for you have instructed me. Lord, I love your commands. Gospel reading. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Luke chapter 4 verse 16 to 30. Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives, and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down, and the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke highly of him, and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They also asked, "Is this not the son of Joseph?" He said to them, "Surely you will quote me this proverb, 'Physician, cure yourself, and say, do here in your native place, the things that we heard were done in Capernaum.'" And he said, "Amen, I say to you, no prophet is accepted in his own native place. Indeed, I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the sky was closed for 3.5 years, and a severe famine spread over the entire land. It was to none of these that Elijah was sent, but only to a widow in Zarephath in the land of Sidon. Again, there were many lepers in Israel during the time of Elisha the prophet, yet not one of them was cleansed, but only Naaman the Syrian." When the people in the synagogue heard this, they were all filled with fury. They rose up, drove him out of the town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their town had been built, to hurl him down headlong. But he passed through the midst of them and went away. The Gospel of the Lord. Before we proceed with the video, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel. Also, please hit the notification bell, so you won't miss out when we release new videos. Feel free to share your comments, suggestions, and reflections at the comments section down below. Thank you and God bless. Now, let's proceed with the video. The reflection on today's Gospel. Of all the texts available to him, Jesus chose this ringing description of his mission from Isaiah: to bring the good news to the poor, to give sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free. As I reflect on Jesus' own understanding of his mission, I look at our world as we struggle with so many social issues: the welcome of refugees and migrants to our countries and communities, the growing inequality between those who have and those who have not, the destruction of the environment. What is the Spirit of the Lord sending me to do? As a follower of Jesus, I ask for the grace not to be deaf to his call, but to carry it out with great generosity. Like the people of Nazareth, I can very easily consider Jesus as my possession, to which I am entitled, someone I already know so well, that he cannot demand anything of me. When he does ask for trust, I can get very angry, claiming I understand him fully while he should know better. I pray for being able to accept the mystery of my relationship to Jesus, for an open, listening heart. Jesus, as he preached about inclusion, found himself excluded. His listeners were appalled at his message. Is there anyone in my community whom I failed to accept? Familiarity with Jesus left his listeners unimpressed. The Word of God made flesh was reading the Word of God to them, and it fell upon deaf ears. Today, let me consciously look for the extraordinary among the ordinary.